What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to Redemption 46 Studios. I'm Nick.
안녕, 로입니다.
Keith.
I'm Zach.
And I'm Jarek.
Y'all know the vibes. Y'all seen the picture. Y'all seen the thumbnail. Y'all know why y'all here. The boys roar. Make sure you work your way over to that subscribe button. Hit it and become a real redeemer today. Also, for more content like this, jump on the Patreon. We're going to be getting into either the dance practice or the studio tune version of this. At some point this month, we'll have a Boys Guide and some other decent content, which I've been banging on the table for this. No long talk. Let's jump into this.
Surprised you ain't you ain't try to do a pun.
Roar your way to this. So either what got H&M canceled? The Jungle joint.
Oh yeah,
God's here.
Yeah, this kind of.
It's like oh. Magical. Shit. Shit. That's the energy I'm getting from the song.
Body rolls, sexy.
Horny him.
Roar.
It's them. Special effects team is going on. Sexy. You feel sexy after that, Keith? You want to roar? I actually respect them for not having like no tiger or lion or nothing in here.
No, but they went
two on the nose.
Two on the. I know it took them a minute. The real lady was like walking with one. And I was like, one of them was walking with it.
They did go vampires.
So. Yeah, that they did. But it would have been so easy just to kind of did this like with a zoo or like a green background and just.
Or so transmorphing.
Yeah, the vampire thing was just like, okay, I get it. I want to see the choreo for this because we were getting limited amounts of it. It's good though,
that
man.
Editing team went crazy though.
Fuck yeah, editing team was fucking going off.
It reminds me of Hot a little bit toward the end too, like the quick cuts.
The slashes.
Yeah.
The animalistic nature of the video.
Yeah, it's a little like cartoonish and anime-ish at certain, especially that third act. It really reminded me of like a I don't even know what anime it was, but like they just look like they were like powering up or some shit like that when they about to transform or something. I know it's not DBZ or anything, but it was another one. It just looked like they were about to power up or something in that third act. I thought it was pretty dope.
A little bleachy
black
too.
Leather.
Bleach. Yeah, bleach. A little bit of bleach.
The black leather joint was kind of tough. It actually looked, remember, I don't know if you remember Drew Hill in my bed video when they do that.
Oh, I know that.
There was no candles in this one though. But
This is pretty dope.
And one of their more sexier songs that I've heard from them. I like this is a download within like the first 20 seconds. So
it's Tattoo Light.
I don't know if anything's going
to say nah. You said sexy, and I thought of that.
No, Tattoo is definitely up there. You know.
Yeah, Tattoo just feel powerful to me. I don't even know.
I'm a nigga.
But, and yes, guys, we know they're not saying that anywhere, but we're going to say it. But like I said, this is pretty dope. I'm not going to fry. I still don't remember my bias's name, but I know what he looks like. So when we do the guide, that's the whole point of us doing the guide. So we'll get to that. But I'm thoroughly impressed with this. I like this.
Yeah, shout out to them too, man. Obviously, you know, when we get in the kingdom and stuff, we'll get more information. And then when we do the guide, we'll get more information too. But regardless of however, you know, anybody on the panel ever feels about the music, you can always see like the hard work, whether it's through the choreo, vocals, rap line, the aesthetics. And for them to be at, a quote-unquote smaller company, the videos are never lacking. The videos always look like millions of dollars were spent on it and shit. Mm-hmm. So
they're always clean.
Yeah, so this was clean. I want to see different outings of the song for different reasons, though. I would want to see the live to see if the energy translated in to kind of hear some of like the vocal runs and stuff. Because we hear them here and there. I think DDD had them. We just talked about Tattoo. But I think I do want to hear like a ballad from them straight up. Like just kind of straight up ballad or something
probably
more.
Probably B-side. We probably got to dive in the B-side for that.
Yeah, and then I would want to see the dance practice just because I know they be acting a fool. You know, last time they were on the channel and shit, some asses were kicked. somebody got to see them again in the choreo.
A beloved ass.
Yeah, so, you know, they like that though.
But yeah, I don't know. I think we should give them a proper rematch with
You can use the same songs again.
No. I mean, because that group who got the ass kicked, they dropped some crazy shit, remember? Oh, no, we already put in the choreo, didn't we?
Yeah.
Damn, we do March Madness or something, maybe, but yeah, because...
Yeah, they definitely going to see some.
That shit
again
was a double deuce.
Yeah, I like this as well. I definitely... That last act was probably, in my opinion, the best part. Like, they just really smoked it. The vocals smoked it. Whoever edited this smoked it. Their dance moves was crazy once the rain was hitting them.
Bring that back. I'm trying to see what them sneaks were.
I was about to say.
I thought those was
McQueen's.
Yeah. Not Black Air Force Energy.
Look at this.
Go back some more, Keith.
That's why I remind me of Hot.
Keith, go back some more.
This shit right. Damn.
It kicked shit hot, too.
Hey.
Yeah, I like this.
Motherfucker.
I got what you need.
The DJ's terrible.
I know, right?
Yeah, that mouse acting slow. That's what it is, ain't it?
I don't know. I can't tell what those are.
They I know. At first, I thought they just was like forces, and they did something. They put the yellow Jane tags Jones, and shit like at the end of it.
They're like K-Swiss.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's
what I it is funny. Somebody be like, say your money and just get Stan Smiths. I like McQueen's. So they a little bit more of a chunkier shoe.
Yeah, I like this overall.
I don't even have this. Oh, yeah, they do.
Coloring on this John is amazing. Everything on this is like, look at that shit. Look. Damn.
You sound sexy, too. Slow down. Yeah, that's actually a lot. That shit. He's funny as shit. Controversy. They did a conjuring effect, too. I love that. Where, like, nothing's there, and then you throw a blanket, and then something, the image is there, and shit like that. It's kind of decent.
They look like regular bowling shoes.
Those are the school 11s.
This might be something. Somebody gonna be in the joint like they Fendi's.
They're low top Doc Martens.
You're too broke to know. Yeah.
Got me.
Fuck us, right?
They're endorsed by Prada.
That's fine.
If you know, send the link.
If you know, get a hookup.
How'd you feel about this?
I really like this video. Like you said, the VFX team, the editors, they snapped. It's different, you know. You don't really see like combat type edits. So it's cool to see that. I love the colors chosen for this. I love the way it was shot. The choreo was very, very interesting. I think it did a great job of bringing the video and the song. The choreo made everything kind of pop a little bit, because I'm not really a big fan of the song itself, but there are moments where, in particular when they're doing the choreo, that I'm like, maybe the song's not that bad. Cool little death drop he did there. Yeah, the video is very nice. I'd love to shoot a video like this. I love the colors. Yeah, that's tough.
I like to sprinkle a little R&B-ness in it.
What was interesting, at least in the first half of the video, I definitely noticed it. A lot of the cuts are incomplete. A lot of the transitions, like, that was an incomplete transition. That's an incomplete transition.
Was it, though?
Like, yeah, because it never, like, they show you the cut, and they show you what's behind it, then they just flash into the screen. They don't kind of zoom in. There's no clean transition between the cut.
Oh, you talking about as far as, like, you, that you don't think it's clean in the sense of somebody else might have did a cut, and then it unravels and followed you kind of through it and stuff.
It's almost like a, like, you kind of just, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, I see what you're saying, but I don't think it was necessary that much.
I mean, I don't think it was. I think it works either way, because it's consistent all the way through the video. Mm-hmm. Even when he, the manhole cover thing, like, when he just kind of steps in and you just see him follow. You never actually see him, like, go in the hole. And you never really just, like, you just see him do the hero landing, but you never see him, like, really hit ground and, like, do the full, you know what I mean? So it's very jumpy throughout the entire video, but it kept theme. But, like, that's just something I kind of noticed in the beginning, because, like Hot was very thorough when it came to doing the transitions. Everything was, like, complete and full, where this kind of has the same vibe, same feel, but not as complete.
Yeah, this is probably, for editing purposes, you probably I'm not going to tell you to stop saying, but it's not complete. I know what you mean, though, and shit. It's When Hot looked like they wanted to do it, they looked like their intention was very much to be like, yo, if I throw the phone at you, when it comes in here, you'll jump into the phone. Or if I throw a sun at you, it'll pan into the sun, and then the sun will be here, and then you'll go here. It was using the movements and zoom-ins as a way to transition into a splice.
Right.
With here, they would do little splice cuts and stuff like that, but they would just cleanly do the transition. Like, we're just going to the next frame. You don't have to use a splice to do anything else to go inside. Yeah. It's not like I'm like, yo, look at the inside of this bottle. And now, like, you go inside the bottle and then something else. It's like, no, nigga, the bottle looks nice.
I think the quick edits like that help the beat drop, or like that drum kicking a little, like, stand out a little bit. Mm-hmm. If you notice, they usually cut it out as soon as, like, that drum kicks in. So
I will say it's very interesting. It made me look at it differently, because chaos, you know how we usually say narrative videos or performance videos. This kind of, like, neither or. Like, you get a little bit of pieces of both, and then it's like just kind of like its own thing. Crazy. It's like a exhibition, if you will, this, like, art.
Yeah. And it did it all here, too. You're right. And it did it all here, too. And I think my thing is just like you said, if it's consistent and it's done on purpose, then it's not jarring, which means, like, it's great editing. Versus where you kind of can see something's incomplete, where it's just like, go watch a bootleg of fucking X-Men Origins or something like that. You can see incomplete, like, CGI work.
Boom, boom, boom. So, like, that was very specific. I feel like this video is canon in the MCU.
They might beat Kang.
Everybody else did.
They might have shot.
Shout out to the Majors unsubscribe.
Lost to a fucking insect. But sure.
Well, that's interesting. Yeah, I'm ready to jump in and see the studio tune version of this so we can get more of the choreo. Anything else you want to add, though?
Studio tune.
Yeah, make sure y'all work your way over there. Subscribe button, man. Come and roll Redeemer today. Jump on the Patreon. We literally about to get into the studio tune version so we can see what the choreo this is hitting for. More content from the boys coming this month. God coming soon. We love you, Redeemers. Gonna holla at y'all. Peace.